Okay, today is our upper body and core. And for our warm up, we're just gonna need a band. And if you don't have a band, a long towel will do, or like a medium sized towel will do if you can just kind of like stretch it out like this. We're just gonna take it up and over. If you don't have either, then you're just gonna take your arms like this. And the whole purpose is just to kind of warm up our shoulders, open up our chest, and wake up our body. All right, so we're gonna take it all the way. Now, if you have to bend your elbows and do like this to get that band over, don't do that. Just go back until you feel a good stretch in your chest, maybe even all the way into your biceps, and take it here. All right, now we're gonna hold it here, and we're just gonna lean to the side and lean to the other side. Feel these lats right here stretch, okay? So try to relax your shoulder muscles and your neck muscles, and just stretch and stretch. And then hinge forward around your back and then slowly come up. All right, so now we're gonna get a little bit more of resistance in the band or the towel, or just use your arms as body weight, and you're just gonna do it like an overhead press, okay? So we're gonna press it up and pull it down. So create a little bit of tension, so by pulling apart the band, press up, pull down, press up, feel your shoulders, pull down, kind of feel your shoulders and back, upper back. All right, just do that a couple more times, and then we're gonna basically do the same thing, push and pull, but we're gonna hinge over in like that bent over row position. So a little bit of resistance on the band, and then you're just gonna hinge and pull, squeezing your back muscles at the top of that movement. Hinge, pull, hinge, pull. It's warming up your whole upper body. All right, stand up. We're gonna take it up and over a couple more times, and then we are gonna get to it. So we have a bunch of different circuits today. And the first one is two exercises. It's gonna be an overhead press and a bent over row. All right, so a push and a pull. We're gonna go three rounds. Every circuit today is two exercises. All right, and then we're gonna finish off with a core little finisher, okay? So put this band away for now. We will come back to it, but not right now. We're gonna use it for triceps later on, okay? All right, so let's get started. We're gonna, whatever weight you can do, three rounds of an overhead press. We have, what is that? Let's see how many reps I say. Eight reps of an overhead press, and then we're gonna hinge over, and we have 10 reps of a bent over row, all right? We rest, and then we do it again. We're gonna go through it three times, all right? So go ahead and grab whatever weight you usually overhead press with, all right? So I'm gonna grab this. And guess what? I have music today. This is a miracle. I'll borrow my daughter's phone. Okay. All right, so don't wanna do it too loud so you can't hear me. Eight reps. Go ahead, put those weights on your shoulders. And then we do 10 bent over rows. All right, look, elbows are out here. Your dumbbells are gonna go straight out and up. Okay, so they're not gonna finish off like this. They're gonna finish off like this at the top. Two, don't use your legs to cheat. Three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Don't drop the weights. If you're gonna use the same weight for your bent over rows, which I think you should, or if you need to go heavier, then you can use heavier weight, but don't go any lighter, okay? Hinge over, 10 rows. One, two, three. Thinking about getting those weights to your hip sockets. Four, five, six, seven. Oh, we're going to 10, right? Eight, nine, and 10. All right, come up out of that hinge and then drop the weight safely to the ground, or you can throw them if you want. All right, so we are going to rest for 30 seconds and then go through it again. I did bring my water this time. Didn't forget it. Really bad habit of forgetting my water down here when I come to film videos. And then complaining about it the whole time. Okay, grab your weights. Ready? 8. 2. Tuck your pelvis. You've got an arch in your lower back. 6. 4. All right. Now hinge it over. 10. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, drop your weights. We have one more round, then we get to move on. Just a little, what's coming up next are bent over flies and lying tricep extensions on the ground. Or a bench, if you have a bench, which we'll be using our bench later. I need to clear mine off. All right, our last round of these guys. All right, grab your weights. Here we go, 8. Take your time, quality reps. 3, 4, 5, oh boy. 6. Seven. This is what you should look like too if you're challenging yourself on this last one. Ooh. All right, don't drop that weight. Bent over row. Here we go. Hinge and row. 3, 4. Two more. Woo! All right. Okay, now we're gonna be doing a bent over fly and a lying tricep extension. So you're gonna wanna go lighter for your weights, because I'm definitely not gonna be able to do this movement here for your fly. And then you're here on the ground, lying, elbows still, extension. All right, so you play around with the weights you want to use. Again, 3 rounds. We go from fly up, reverse flies to triceps, and then we rest. Ready? Hinge over, core is pulled on, and back is flat, just like this. Okay, elbow slightly bent. 1. See how I'm kind of taking it back a little bit also. 3, 4, 5, 6, 10. Oh, okay. And Joe forgot how many we were doing. Okay. Oh, 15 of these guys. So that also makes a difference in what you're using. All right. Look, elbows are going to be, I'm going to show you from this angle, really still. You're gonna take that weight here. Oops. 2. You probably could go a little bit heavier with this one, but I'm gonna just stick with it. 10. We have 5 more. Ow. I need away from the squat rack. Hurt myself over here. All right, and come up, leave the dumbbells on the ground, and let's rest.
10 flies, 15 triceps.
All right, grab your weights. Here we go. 2. All right, right back down to the ground. 15. Make sure you get full extension of the elbow at the top. Taking that dumbbell as low as you possibly can. I lost count, so I'm gonna do 3 more. Told you I'm the world's worst counter. All right, leave it. Leave the dumbbells. Shake out your arms, and then we're right back to our flies. All right, coming up next, we have a dumbbell pullover and a band tricep press down. So, oh boy, more triceps. Fun. Okay. All right, flies, let's go. Safely come down and grab your weight. That wasn't actually safely. Okay, here we go. 10, 1, 2, 3. Feel the back of your shoulders, upper back also. And 10, all right, back down to the ground. Last 15, triceps, here we go. You hear my kids, they're playing, they're not fighting actually, they're just excited playing the new Nintendo Switch. And I warned them before I came in here, please be quiet, don't scream and yell. But, you know, in one ear and out the other. This is getting really hard, guys. I'm trying to distract you. Oh, goodness. And we have more triceps coming up. Yuck. Last one. Okay. Well, we're going to drop these weights. And we're going to need one heavy dumbbell. Now, if you don't have a heavy dumbbell, you can use a band. You can, like, anchor a band behind you somewhere and grab a dumbbell and kind of do a pullover, sorry, a band and do a pullover like that. I'll kind of show you with this band right here. So if you don't have a heavy dumbbell to do a pullover, you can try to anchor in a band like this. And then keeping your arms nice and straight, try to pull it down. Okay, because we want to be working our side bodies. Elbows are straight. All right, now, if you have a dumbbell and you want to do this on the ground, you can. Watch. Most people will. Here. Okay? If you have a bench, you could do this on a bench so you could get more range of motion. So that dumbbell can go lower than the floor, right? So you get a little bit more oomph at the bottom. But I'm just going to stay here because I don't feel like flipping back and forth and moving stuff around. So we have a pullover, and then we're going to grab a band, have the band anchored in somewhere above your shoulder height, preferably above or right around your head or higher. All right, so 3 rounds again. Here we go. 1 pullover. Let me see how many we're doing. Oh, pullover. Oh, 12. All right, and then triceps, 12. Easy, 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 easy. All right, elbows stay the same, same bend of the elbows, same angle the whole time. 1, 2, try to get
that dumbbell to hit the ground or as close as you can. We got four more. Stretch. And last one. Okay, all right, now pop up. You're going right to your band. You're gonna keep your elbows the same position here so your elbows don't move. You're just gonna take your hands and pull them down. Oh my gosh. That does not feel great after those dumbbell lying triceps. Now, if it's too easy, you're gonna back away from the anchor point, but don't worry, I will not be doing that. Shoulders back. 11 and 12. That is so painful. Sorry about that. Three rounds, we got two more to go. Grab water, quick sip. We don't need a lot of time to recover between these exercises because our heart rate's pretty low. These aren't super challenging for our cardiovascular system, but really challenging for my triceps today. I don't know what's going on, if it's just me or what, but I'm struggling. Okay. Let's go, on the ground, round two. All right, ready? Scooch up this way, and go. Feel your chest. On this one too, if you're pressing into the weights by the sides, you engage your chest muscles a little bit more. When you get to 12, popping back up and grabbing that band. Now, I forgot to mention, should have said this before on the first round, but if you don't have a band, you can use a dumbbell over your head and just go into a standing tricep overhead extension. But I know most of my clients, if not all, have bands. So, but if you're somewhere where you don't have access to your bands, that is your option, right? All right, 12. Oh boy. One more round. Oh, can't wait until this circuit's over. So just to kind of give you an idea what we're doing next, we have a floor press and then we're doing our core circuit. So it's actually kind of two in one, but floor press is a lying heavier dumbbells. And your elbows are kind of starting here, and then we extend instead of like a chest press. It's more kind of like front delts, a little bit of chest, but like I don't like to work the chest a lot. Nobody wants like big muscles here. Females don't usually. Okay, all right, so let's go. Okay, here we go. Pullovers, last round, hallelujah. Two, make sure your lower back is pulled into the floor. Your abs are engaged. And your lower back's pressed in. So you have to tilt your pelvis up a little bit. Should be challenging. If it's easy, you need to straighten out your elbows a little bit, okay? Less bend in the elbows. Okay, I think that was 12, but you know me, start talking again, lost count. All right, 12 here.
Here we go. Look, elbows, I mean shoulders are pulled down away from your ears, and go. Two, three, think about pressing down and extend. See how my arms are kind of extending out, or my hands are extending out. Two more. Oh, all right, okay. So get rid of the band, and you're gonna need two heavy-ish weights that you can do your floor press with. So we are gonna be doing three rounds of this. We're gonna be doing 10 floor presses. If you want to, you can do these on a bench also, but you don't have to. If you do have access to a bench, you can lie flat on the bench or have it at a little bit of an incline if you'd like. Then we are going to be doing, sprinter sit-ups and reverse crunches. All right, so here we go. Three rounds this circuit, three exercises. All right, so 10 floor presses. Go ahead and grab your weights. Take your elbows right here, and you're gonna press up and right back down, okay? Elbows are coming into the side body. Take your time with these, go heavy. You can only get like 8, that's fine too, if it's a heavier dumbbell. All right, go ahead. Drop those weights. Reverse crunch. Okay, take your hands here, or if you want to, you could like hold behind you like this if you have like a dumbbell or something. Holding something behind your head, I feel like allows you to get up a little bit higher with your reverse crunch, and it gives me more control on the way back down instead of just slamming my hips back into the ground. All right, forgot to tell you, we're doing 12 of these. So I'm not sure what number you're on, but once you get to 12, we're going to our sprinter sit-ups. And this is probably 12. Now, sprinter sit-ups are these. You're gonna have your elbow meet, your right elbow meet your left knee. One, two, three, four, five, six, you're going to 8, 7, and 8. Other side. Oh my gosh. 1, 2, 3. Draw your belly button in. Seven and eight. Never thought I'd be so excited to pick up these weights to go back to my floor press. All right. Grab them, they should be right beside you. Go ahead and lean back, 12, 10, go. 3. All right, drop those weights. Grab your, whatever you're gonna use for your reverse crunches, and 12. Nice and slow. Relax your neck. Last one. Oh, all right, sprinter sit-ups, here we go. 8 and 8. Oh boy. Six. Seven. And 8. We gotta do the other side. It's brutal. And we have one more round. 2, 3, 4. Oh my gosh. 5, 6, 7, and 8. Oh, this is so much fun, so much fun. All right, lean it back. 10 more presses. This is it, third round. Okay, and go. All right, okay, 12 reverse crunches, go ahead, and go. Nice and slow up, nice and slow down, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, two more. 11 and 12. Okay, here it is. Okay, I'm mentally preparing myself. Ready and go. 8. Suffering with you today. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Other side, last 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Okay, we are done. All right, so if you would like to cool down, I'd go ahead and just grab your band and kind of do the same thing we did in the beginning to warm up. Just opening up your chest and shoulders like so, and maybe do a couple of cat-cow to kind of stretch that back and core. Oh, feels good. All right, so hope you enjoyed this. I want you to try to do this upper body twice this week, and your lower body workout at least twice too. You will also be getting a HIIT video, so that can be done as a bonus. All right, well, I hope you have a great day and see you soon.